Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. My name is Emily and I make loads of videos about Salesforce. Today we're going to be continuing on with our developer series and we're going to talk about one triggers as well as creating a new context variable or using a .new context variable within Salesforce. So let's go ahead and jump in to the developer console. And oops, I accidentally clicked out of it. Let's go ahead and go new. Trigger. This is going to be opportunity test. Trigger. And go find opportunities. I went too far. All right, hit opportunity and submit. Okay, so it creates the opportunity trigger for us. So there are six different kinds of triggers. And let's go over this before so we can get a little bit more familiar with it. So the six different kinds are either going to be a before or an after trigger, and they're going to either be before insert, update, or delete, or after insert, update, and delete. So insert is creating a net new record, update is updating a current record, and deleting is, of course, deleting a record. These different types of context variables that we have help us to do things with those records that are returned to us. So let's say before insert of an opportunity, which is our example, this is going to return to us any net new opportunities. And then based upon a certain set of criteria, we can manipulate those new opportunities to go to certain places or to have certain data points that we want them to always have. Of course, this can be done with a flow. Previously, if you're just doing a field update, it could have been done with a workflow rule, but I digress. This is just an example. So let's actually go ahead and hop into it. First, let's go ahead and create our variable. Opportunity O equal dot new. Okay, and then I created a field just to be able to test this. So I'm going to go back into the object and grab the API name of it. Of course, I could grab and just do the API name myself, but I want to make sure that this is right because I did not account for fully capitals or fully lowercase on this like I should have. O dot test for new trigger. This is going to be a number field, so I'm just going to have this be 31 because this is the 31st of March. Hit save. And because this is the 31st of March, I just want to have it be a weird number that's not like standard and possibly could have gotten there by some other automation. Alrighty, so I am running into one little error here. It is an illegal assignment, so I'm just going to enter in that the first record that is inserted, that it will be the one that is updated. So let's go ahead and now that this is saved, let's go ahead and go in and validate that this has been updated. The trigger has been activated. So opportunity trust trigger. Let's make sure, yep, it is here. It is active. So let's go ahead and go back to opportunities and go to opportunity name, test opportunity. Let's do close date today, next step, because I know that I'll throw an error prospecting, and save. All right, let's go ahead and make sure that our number, test number for trigger is there. So we have successfully created a trigger with the new variable. I hope you found this helpful. I am dipping my toes into the development world and creating more developer tutorials. It can be really frustrating sometimes, but if you like this video, be sure to give it a thumbs up, subscribe if you're feeling generous, and check out my courses down below. Thanks.